deceitfulness and theft category. And this is a breaking in into people's houses. Lies. A lot of times will lie even when they don't need to. Just takes things without using any force or threatening anybody directly. And then a serious violation of rules have to do with staying out past the curfew. It's interesting about the running away from home that they've got to do it at least twice and be away overnight. Running down the block and parents losing track for an afternoon of where their child is doesn't really qualify for running away with this set of criteria. And then, of course, being in a trunk from school. And it's significant here that the school problems, and in particular the school truancy, has to start before age 13. So, and then there's the code types of onset of the disorder. Childhood is before age 10, and adolescent onset is age 10 or above. And this is important to be aware of because, as we'll see, the early onset is particularly difficult and troubling as far as future prognosis being quite poor. And then there's the severity of specifiers from mild to which again, as we'd seen from the criteria, that there is often a continuum there of severity of behaviors, and as we'll see here in just a moment too, that the the mild specifier I think can kind of overlap into some other diagnoses possibly, but and then going on up to from moderate. Which just gets into things that are a little more severe, such as vandalism and stealing kinds of things, but not into the severe category, which has to do with actually forcing either sexual activity or using a weapon to perpetrate a crime, or if there's just a lot of the 15 that the kid qualifies for.